Welcome to the Ambulance Suite at the University of Northampton. This is where we do most of our practical scenarios when we're training you to be a paramedic, and we've got lots of fancy equipment for you to explore. One of our main pieces of equipment we use is this, which is actually an iPad, but it's designed to simulate anything that we want to replicate for a monitor that you'd use out in ambulance practice. And what's really good is if they update the software for this, or you use different monitors out on the road, then actually we can mimic that out on the road as well. And it's exactly the same as the equipment you'll use when you're out on ambulance placement. So for example, if we wanted to do a blood pressure, you can press the blood pressure button, makes the noise and actually pumps up and will display in a short amount of time. I'll just stop that because it's quite loud, it sounds like an aeroplane going over. The other thing that it can do is actually print off 12 lead ECGs, which helps tell us whether you're having a heart attack or not. So you select the age and the sex, and then it would print out like a real ECG would, and we train you how to interpret these so you can tell whether patients are having a heart attack or not, which is really good from a lifelike point of view. You'll notice we're in the back of the ambulance as well, and what we tend to do is actually enclose students in here. We've got the real life monitor here, we've got cameras up here, and it will be as close as you can get to being in the back of the ambulance when you're out on placement. And we feed in all the inputs through either an iPad, which will replicate any observations we want on the screen there, or we can control our lifelike mannequin through this bit here. So we'll go and have a look at our mannequins and how it replicates real life. So I appreciate they don't look very real, and they look a little bit scary if you look at them in the eyes, but what the bonus of these mannequins are is you'll see that it's actually breathing there. So in the past, simulation used to be where you'd walk in and the tutor would have to tell you what they're finding. Now, you will come into the back of the ambulance, we won't have any input because we're at the back watching the monitors, and then you will assess, is the patient breathing? And you can see there, if you see my hand moving, you can see that patient's breathing absolutely fine. You can check to see if it's got a pulse in its wrist, a pulse in its neck. Also, we can check the airway. So there's things where we can swell the airway up to look like it's an allergic reaction. You can make the mannequin scream if you do anything that causes them pain at all. You can make them cough. We can replicate lung sounds. So eventually you're going to come in into this environment and assess and treat as you find without any inputs from the tutors at all. And the overall aim is that we make this as real and replicated practice as much as possible, really.